Hello, Airbus Cockpit Coach here. You're joining me in the flight deck of the Fenix A320, and in this video we're going to look at the cruise. We're just approaching our cruise level of flight level 320. I'm just passing over the Trent VOR, Mach Altstar. So remember always to announce your FMAs. So we're now acquiring the cruising altitude. Engines are spooling back a little bit. Mach Alt cruise. Depending on your altitude, you may want to put the transponder into below. So in the event of a rapid decompressurization, you'd want a deep view of traffic. For some airlines, that is in their standard operating procedures. It's fine to leave it where it is, but below is also a good option there. Once we reach our cruise, we want to have a look at our status on the ECAM. We're in the cruise page here, which gives us a very good summary of all the key information, such as what's going on with our engines in terms of oil quantity, fuel use, vibrations. We've got the cabin air temperature, cabin pressure, the cabin altitude, our airfield elevation for landing, and then we've got outside air temperatures and time and gross weight here as well. Now we want to have a bit of a detailed look at our systems. To flick through these, you can do them one by one, or you could hold down the all page. If you hold that button down, it will scan through. I'm going to do it individually now as I talk through them. So on the engine page, we want to make sure that we've got sensible oil quantities and our temperatures and vibrations are looking sensible. You can detect problems in the ECAM pages before they reach the system limit, so before ECAM warnings or cautions are triggered, we can detect things by flicking through these pages, so it is important to do. Checking our temperatures there again on the blue page, it's all looking sensible. Pressure, cabin altitude, cabin pressure there as well. Electrics, both generators online. We check how much they're being utilised. So we've got 23%, 18% over there. That's all looking sensible. Hydraulics, check of our quantities. We've got the green there, which is showing a bit low. That does happen in some situations, so it's not necessarily an issue. We generally won't get an ECAM until it starts getting much lower than that, so it's something we would keep an eye on if we saw indications which were trending a little bit lower than where the recommended values are. We look at our fuel, making sure that's balanced, and if there are any differences in terms of balance, we want to understand why that is, so we always need to answer that question. Why have I got more in the left than the right? Quite often it's because we had the APU on, for example, so we need to understand why that is. APU, expect that to be off. Got our temperatures in the cabin, all looking comfortable. Doors, making sure they're all closed and armed still. Wheel page, want to have a look at our temperatures, making sure that our braking performance is going to be decent on landing. On this page, we generally expect the flight controls to all be around the neutral mark, as trim is being primarily used in the cruise to adjust our flight controls. Then we bring it back to the cruise page and we'll leave it on there. Next thing we need to do is conduct a fuel check. So in the cruise, this is done every 30 minutes or passing over a waypoint, so we don't want to leave it more than 30 minutes. And to do this, we come to our flight plan page. And it's very handy, so we've got the fuel for the last waypoint that we've overflown, so which is Tango November Tango, Trent. Come over to the right, the fuel on board there was 4.3. We passed that at 11.36, so it's 11.36, 4.3 tonnes. Come over to the flight log, and we find Trent. And we've got 3.5 tonnes there, so we're good on fuel. and we'd make a log of that as we pass over those waypoints. So that's where you can see that's useful to know that the last waypoint function is there, so remember that. Now during cruise we may want to perform step climbs. We're on a short flight today, so we're not going to do that, but you would come over to your flight plan page to do this, and you would select on the right line select key. You've got step altitudes, and if you just entered an altitude which was a more efficient one than you've got now, you can put in 380 for example, write that into the system. The system would recommend where that altitude is and where you should step climb. Because we're on a short flight today, it's not done that, we want to be heading down soon, but that's how you would do that in the MCDU. Next we want to come onto the init page, and we may need to perform a wind request, so the winds are updated every 6 hours. If we're 6 hours from the last wind update, we can run a wind request. It's probably a good idea to do it anyway, just to double check, and that will update our winds for the cruise and descent, making sure we've got the most accurate data on board. Also during cruise we want to check the weather for our alternate aerodromes. That's really important, so we're always thinking ahead. Good airmanship is all about, you know, the what ifs, planning ahead of the aircraft, and you know, we could get a medical emergency at any time on board. We may need to divert, so we always want to be looking at our weather situation. And we can do this on the EFB. We do have weather for the alternate here, which is Manchester today. Or you can use your MCDU, so you come down to the ATC comms page, go to link at the bottom there, AOC menu, and we go to WX, which is weather requests, and we put the code in for the aerodrome you want to request. We could go off Charlie for example, and we probably want the METAR, yes, and send, and that will give us a message back with that weather on. We go to the receive messages section. There we go, we've got weather data, and there is the METAR, the current METAR for Manchester. So that's really important to do. We want to keep an eye on that as we're going along, always checking weather en route at our destination and our alternates. So those are the things that will keep us occupied during cruise. If you have any questions on any of that, please drop them in the comments, and don't forget to hit like and subscribe to stay up to date with the latest content. I'll see you on the next one. Thanks for watching.